Taylor speaks righteous. Sister Cena says funky. How was I? How was I? How was I?
After everything we've been through!
Bags! Coming and slaying the whole underworld. Hella fucking extra. Yeah.
To the person who stole the pride flag off our front porch.
We're so sorry a rainbow bruised your fragile ego.
But don't worry, we have next day Amazon Prime. You can keep taking our flag, but you can never take our pride. Oh, and smile, you're on camera. Love the big ol' homos who live here.
Some guys have been asking me, why does bottoming hurt? Is it the size? Maybe. Is it the position? Perhaps. Is it the top that doesn't know what the hell they're doing? Most likely. But I digress. One of the reasons why bottoming probably hurts is because you need to relax. What happens is, when you're not relaxed, the muscles in your back area really tighten up. You cannot brace yourself for impact. You have to just let it happen. And when I say relaxing, I don't mean just your physical body. You also need to relax your mind. To all my top guys out there, you should take a little responsibility to make sure that your bottom is relaxed and prepared.
The flavor, you know what I mean? We love it. Moving on.
Three really weird gay facts that'll make you smarter than your history teacher. And the last one's a bit dirty. Your school censored 5 pages of Anne Frank's diary. She wrote, "Every time I see a female nude, such as the Venus in my art history book, I go into ecstasy. Sometimes I find them so exquisite I have to struggle to hold back my tears. If only I had a girlfriend." Doctors thought bicycles in the early 1900s would turn women gay because the seat tickled them. And this is dirty. Christmas actually started as a gay festival in Rome where men would play around naked and tops became bottoms. I can't wait for part 4.
I got a question for all the homophobic parents out there on TikTok. So, what exactly is your plan when you talk to Jesus one day? No, seriously, I'm curious. I told those homos that you didn't love them. And Jesus is like, I never said that. I told them that they were going to hell. And he's like, I never said that. I told them that they had turned away from God and that they were an abomination. I never said that. Where exactly is your child? Because I haven't heard from him lately. I told him that you didn't love him. They're not Christian anymore. That's your plan. Because let me tell you something. The only person going to hell is you. I'm not afraid to kneel at the feet of Jesus. Not for one second. Because I spend my life trying to explain to your children that God still loves them. He always has.
Offensive gay jokes that are actually pretty funny. What do gay men call hemorrhoids? I don't know, what? Speed bumps. Hey, how do you fit 4 gay guys on 1 bar stool? How? Turn it upside down. Did you know only 75% of gay men were born that way? Oh, well, what happened to the other 25%? They were sucked into it.
Now from the top, make it drop, that's so wet, that's so wet. Now get a bucket and a mop, that's so wet, that's so wet.
I ain't never seen all straight siblings. One of them always gotta be gay.
I'm that bitch.
It goes on and on and on. And then we start to dance and I'm singing like,
oh, I want something just like this.
Might be over now, but I feel it still.
Alec and I met in 2013 when our mutual friend Brian introduced us at Alec's birthday party and we became inseparable the rest of the night. I was the first guy Alec ever kissed in public. We went on a few dates and became boyfriends in just a few weeks. Alec got into medical school shortly after we started dating and he now works as an OBGYN doctor. We love to travel together, especially anywhere with a beach or water. We don't see a lot of each other with his schedule these days, but love to goof around and go on adventures, even little ones, whenever we get the chance. We added a new member of our family in 2018, Riley, our cat. In 2019, I proposed to Alec in a bamboo forest in Japan. He said yes, and we spent the rest of the year planning our wedding and getting ready to be husbands. In the meantime, Alec graduated medical school, and we got used to being engaged during residency. Unfortunately, we had to postpone our wedding for a year due to the coronavirus, but we still wanted to get married this year, so we wrote some vows, threw on some suits, and had a socially distanced wedding ceremony with just our immediate families, everyone standing 6 feet apart. It's weird not being able to hug your parents, and it wasn't what we planned, but it was still perfect.
Four popular ocean animals you didn't know were gay. Number one, dolphins. Most, if not every single dolphin is actually bisexual. However, some species of dolphins or individuals will go through periods of only being attracted to either the same or the opposite sex, and then they could even form long-term partnerships. Number two, penguins. Penguins have actually been known to form same-sex lifelong partnerships. Here we see two penguins named Roy and Silo, and they have a baby that they hatch named Tango, which is really cute. They're in the Bronx Zoo, and I love penguins. Number three, orca whales. This is actually the largest species in the dolphin family, and orca whales have been known to have same-sex or gay partners, but most of them are actually bisexual, which is pretty cool, so we love a bisexual orca whale icon. Yeah, they're really cute. Number four, walruses. Most male walruses are actually gay until about 4 years of age, or until they're able to have kids, then they become bisexual during mating season, and then a lot of the times they'll just go back to being gay, and they've even been known to raise kids together.
So in high school, my buddy Dave and I were dared to play gay chicken.
If you don't know what gay chicken is, it's where two straight guys pretend to be gay, and the first one to chicken out loses. So anyways, Dave and I are both really, really stubborn, and neither of us want to lose. We've been married for 14 years now, run a bed and breakfast in Florida with our adopted daughter. If he doesn't chicken out soon, I'm gonna suspect he's actually gay.
Three really weird gay facts that'll make you smarter than your history teacher. And the last one's a bit dirty. Leonardo da Vinci was arrested for gay sex twice. If he was found guilty, we wouldn't have the Mona Lisa because they would have killed him. In the 1970s, the state of Connecticut refused to give a gay man a driver's license because they said being gay made him too dangerous to other drivers. Okay, this one is dirty. In the 1700s, a lesbian put a leather horn in her pants and disguised herself as a man so nobody would punish her for hooking up with women. She also used that leather horn as a funnel to urinate standing up. Part two is gonna be even better than this